Hello friends, welcome to Night Graphics. We are discussing the chapter of line and distribute, and this is the third video on this. In the first two videos, we have discussed about all the options related to aligning and distributing objects. And in this video, we will discuss about distribute spacing. If you have not watched the first two videos related to aligning and distributing the objects, I would recommend you to watch them first to have a better idea of what we will discuss now. Link of those videos are flashing up here, or you can explore channel's playlist. Okay, coming to our topic now. Distribute spacing simply means distribution of space between the objects. While these options of distributing objects distribute objects between the space. If you have watched and understood my previous video on distributing objects, you will have a clear understanding of the difference between the two. Let's have a practical. Here we have 5 rectangles. I select them all. And here we have two options for distribute spacing. First is vertical distribute space and second is horizontal distribute space. Notice that right now the option of align to artboard is selected. So if I press horizontal distribute space, Illustrator will use the horizontal space of artboard, which is this, and place all the 5 objects in such a way that the space between them will be equal, like this. In case of uneven shapes, like here we have, this result cannot be achieved by any of these options of distribute objects. Now I am choosing the option of align to selection. I am pressing Ctrl Z to undo this move. Now if I press this button, it will use the horizontal space of selection area, which is this, and place all the 5 objects in such a way that the space between them will be equal, like this. Let's undo this move again. Now I am choosing the option of align to key object. And notice now, this field is active. Illustrator has selected this shape as key object. However, I want this rectangle to be the key object. So I click over it once to make it key object. And now I will enter the desired space here. Here I have entered 50 points and press this button. And now all the objects are horizontally 50 points away from each other. Right? Coming to the next example, here again we have 5 rectangles. I select them all. I'm choosing the option of align to artboard and press this button of vertical distribute space. So now Illustrator will use the vertical space of artboard, which is this, and place all the 5 objects in such a way that the space between them will be equal, like this. Now I'm choosing the option of align to selection. I'm pressing Ctrl Z to undo this move. Now if I press this button, it will use the vertical space of selection area, which is this, and place all the 5 objects in such a way that the space between them will be equal, like this. Let's undo this move again. Now I'm choosing the option of align to key object. Illustrator has selected this shape as key object. However, I want this rectangle to be the key object. So I click over it once to make it key object and now I will enter the desired space here. Here I have entered 50 points and press this button and now all the selected objects are vertically 50 points away from each other. Alright? Then at last we have an option of use preview bounds here in the panel's option. If this option is ticked, Illustrator will consider the height and width of the effects applied to an object while aligning and distributing. Here is a short example of it. Here we have 4 identical squares. Size is 50 by 50 points. Right now, the use preview bounds option is unticked. Now I'm applying drop shadow effect to these 2 squares. Again, if I check the measurement of this square, it is showing 50 by 50 only. But if you tick this option now, and then check its measurement, it is showing 80.16 by 80.16 points. Because now, the effects applied to it is also considered by Illustrator. You also have the access to this option in the preference settings under General. So the alignment and distribution functions will be affected due to this option. Like here, I am selecting these 2 squares, use preview bounds is ticked, And let's distribute space between them by selecting this square as key object and entering space value to be 150 points. Remember that Illustrator has assumed this square's width and height to be 80.16 points because this option is ticked. Okay, now let's do the same thing for these two squares, but now with this option unticked. Now Illustrator will assume the size of the square to be 50 by 50 points only while distributing space of 150 points. And here is the result. You can notice that there is a small difference. So this was all about align and distribute functions. I hope I was able to make you clear everything about this concept in this and last two videos. Practice with these functions to properly absorb the concept in your mind. Thanks for watching NatGraphics. Hit like and share this video if you find it good, and don't forget to subscribe for more upcoming tutorials.